Hi, my name's Troy, and I am a school psychologist. I work with kiddos who are kindergarten through 12th grade, and I absolutely love it because I get to help kids who sometimes might think they don't have the same abilities as others really succeed. And I also love to work with young men or young boys and help them figure out what their value is and kind of what their strengths are and what they can do. The reason it's so exciting for me to be able to work with young kids and help them work through stuff in their life is because when I was young, around 14, 15 years old, my parents had a pretty messy divorce that really messed with me. What it felt like to me was like I had had this orange in my hand. You know, we all know what an orange is. It's pretty basic. I'd had this orange in my hand for a long, long time, and I knew it was an orange, and I just looked at it, and I'm like, oh, that's an orange. It's no big deal. Didn't really think about that being anything else. And then one day I looked away, and I looked back, that orange was an apple. And that's what my parents divorcing felt like to me, because I had been grown up or raised in this perfect little bubble where I was homeschooled and my dad was a pastor, and everything was just like, oh, I believed everything because I was told it. Well, in that moment when that orange turned to an apple and my parents had divorced, everything that I believed just broke. Everything that everyone had told me was true, I now had to question, and it really wrecked me. So the way that all played out in my life and what really hit me was, what does it mean to be a man? Because I, at that point, I mean, I was 14 years old, not many 14-year-olds are really trying to figure out what being a man is, but I was starting to try to figure that out, and all of a sudden, everything I'd been taught about being a man or being anything, I was questioning. And so I had to try to define that on my own, and I threw everything I knew to the side, and all of a sudden I'm identifying my manhood and how many people can I get to like me or tell me that I'm awesome, or how many girls can I date or hook up with, or how much money can I make. And so I became very relentless in the pursuit of these things because I was trying to fill, it sounds kind of cliche, but trying to fill the void or the hole that I had in myself with something that made me feel whole, that made me feel like a man. And the more I chased those things, the more I succeeded at those things, the more that it was just empty. The more I realized that no matter how many girls I date or hook up with, or how much money I make, or how many cars I had, or motorcycles, or mountain bikes, or how big the house I lived in was, and how many people I could have money with, or how many drinks I could buy for everybody at the bar that night, how many of those things I could do to make myself feel like the big deal or something important, the more empty I became, and the less important I became, and the less of myself I knew. I became something that was not me, and I knew it, and I could tell that there was something tearing me apart from the inside. And really, all those things that I was trying to be, I don't know if anybody is supposed to be those things. You're trying to put your value in things that don't matter. Once I realized what I was created to be, and I got to do what I'm doing now with kids, and as a dad, and as a husband, and I get to protect and provide and be a man for the people that truly need me to be a man, I am more fulfilled in my manhood than I ever would have been had I continued chasing those dumb dreams, ever. And I feel just like that little airplane, that my creator, who made me with a purpose, grabbed me out of the mud and said, listen, dummy, Troy, you have no idea what you're made for. Let's go this way. And he gently coaxed me toward the direction that I was supposed to be. And once I saw what I could not see, and I started going the direction that I was made to go, my manhood was established. And I'm continuing to strive after that. It's a continued journey. None of us have made it yet. None of us are perfect. So I continue to have flaws, and that's great because I still surround myself with good men. But I would challenge each of you, anybody watching this, to evaluate what you were created to be. Guarantee you it's not playing video games. Guarantee you it's not drinking the most, getting most girls, all that kind of stuff. This might be fun, and they might work for a minute, but they're not gonna fulfill you as a man. My name is Troy, and I challenge you to man up.